Hi guys, welcome to the channel. It's me Matangi and today we are going to see about how to perform virtual screening in Autodoc Vina software. So first let me give an introduction about what is virtual screening. Virtual screening is a computational technique. We use that technique to screen or filter the small molecules that are likely to be bind to our target's molecule specific site with the least binding energy. So that's the sole purpose of the virtual screening process. So virtual screening, it's basically of two types. First one is the target-based virtual screening, and second one is the ligand-based virtual screening. In the first type, that is the structure or target-based virtual screening, we know the target molecule, but we don't know the small molecules that are likely to be bind to our target molecule. So we have to find those small molecules. In the second type, we know the small molecule, but we don't know the target molecule to which this small molecule binds with. So in the first type, we know the target molecule, we don't know the ligand molecule. In the second type, we know the ligand molecule, we don't know the target molecule. So that's the major difference. And today we are going to see about the we are going to perform the structure or target based virtual screening. So to perform virtual screening, we need the receptor molecule and the ligand molecules. So I am already taking the available structure in the protein data bank, and that is the 1m7q. So in 1m7q, there's already a ligand present in this protein molecule. So that this is the ligand DQO. So just copy this name and paste in PubChem. You will get the information about the molecule, the molecule's 2D and the 3D structure and all. And when you go down, you can get this initial key. Just copy and paste this initial key and copy and paste this initial key in this zinc database. Here you can see the ligand structure, that is the DQO structure. So now I am going to screen the small molecules or filter the small molecules that are having the similar structure of my ligand DQO. So that's why I'm going to screen the molecules that are having the similar structure to my ligand's structure, and I'm going to make those screened small molecules to bind with my protein's ligand binding site to which the original ligand, the DQO, actually binds into. So that's why I'm going to do. So I'm going to search for the ligand molecules that are having the 40% similarity, that is structure similarity, with my ligand molecule. So now I'm getting those molecules. There are 8 of them. So 8 molecules I'm getting. So just go to each molecule and download those molecules in the STF format. Once you click here, you can get your ligand molecule downloaded in the STF format. So you have downloaded your ligand molecule in the STF format. You have to convert your ligand molecule from STF format to the PDB format. So for that, just go to PyMOL, file, open. Okay, open your STF file. So I already have those files. I already converted those files. I'm just showing you here as an example. So this is the ligand molecule which is in the STF format. So now I'm going to save this in a PDB format. So just go to file, export molecule, selection, ligand name, then save. Then save here, save as type in the PDB format and give any name as you wish. Okay, so now this is how you should save your ligand molecules from the STF to the PDB format. So once you have saved all your ligand molecules to the PDB format and you already have your receptor molecule in the PDB format, so for a virtual screening, we need those receptor and the ligand molecules in the PDB QT format, and also we need a configuration file, that is the configuration file that contains the XYZ parameters and all dimensions and all. So for that, just go to Autodoc file, read molecule. So this is the receptor molecule in the PDB format. You have to save this receptor molecule in the PDB format in the following steps as you normally do in the protein preparation in the Autodoc. So just go to edit, delete water, edit hydrogens, add hydrogens, polar only, okay. Then edit charges, add Coleman charges, okay. Then edit charges, compute gas figure, okay. Then after adding all charges, hydrogens and deleted water, then go to grid macromolecule, choose 1M7Q, select. This is how you should save your receptor file in the PDB QT format. So just save it. So after you saved your receptor file in the PDB QT format, now it's time for you to save your ligand files to your in your PDB format, to the PDB format. So just go to ligand input, open, just change to PDB format. So now you are having all your ligands in the PDB format. So now you have to change your ligand from PDB to PDB QT. So select the ligand, okay. Ligand torsion tree direct route, ligand torsion tree choose torsions, done. Ligand torsion tree set number of torsions, then ligand output save as PDB QT. So this is how you should save each of your ligand file in the PDB QT format. So once you have saved all your ligand molecule in the PDB QT format, now it's time for us to go for the configuration. That is, we want our grid box parameters to create the configuration file. The configuration file is just the file just to direct direct the ligand molecules to exactly which site the ligand molecules should bind. So it's just directing the way to which the ligand molecule should bind the exact site. So just adjust your grid box and place exactly on the specific site to which you want your ligand molecule should go and bind to the target molecule site. So just place your grid box onto the exact specific site. So once you have adjusted all this, just go to file, close saving current, then grid box file, output grid dimensions file. So grid dot txt, just save it. So once you have saved this, now we got to create the configuration file. So first let me this is the protocol for how to perform virtual screening in the Autodoc Vina. So this is the protocol that I prepared by myself, I created by myself. So in the first, you can see I have mentioned what are the files that should be present in your virtual screening folder. That is, you have to create a folder for virtual screening, and in that folder you have to keep all the files that you are needed to do virtual screening in the Autodoc Vina. So in the caution, I have shown that there should be no spaces in any of your folder's name or file's name. So just remind that, don't don't have any spaces in between, your Autodoc won't run, your Autodoc Vina won't run. So the files that got to be in your virtual screening folder, first one is the receptor file in your PDB format. So yeah, we did that. Then the individual ligand files in the PDB QT format, so we also did that. And third one is the configuration file. We should save this configuration file as conf underscore vs.txt. In the configuration file, it contains the following information as this. So I have already created my configuration file. So here you can see the configuration file. So wait. So from your grid file that which you created in the Autodoc, with the help of that grid file, you have to create this configurations file. So this is the center X, center Y, center Z, and this is the size X, size Y, size Z. So just place those, copy those values here, and just I have mentioned here the receptor file is the 1m7q underscore apo. I didn't have any spaces in between the names, so you should remember there should be no spaces in your any of your folders name or the files name. So size X 40 40 40, then number of modes, this is the standard 110, then energy range equal to 4, this is also a standard one. So once you have created all this configuration file, so next step is, the next file is, we should have the Windows Perl script file. So this is the file we must have to run the virtual screening in Autodoc Vina in Windows. So we should we must have this Windows Perl script file. So I will also give this file's link in the description box. Just check this out. And in the fifth, we need all the Vina files. All these three Vina files, so you can get these files from here. So just go to Windows C, programs file, and the scripts research file. Okay, the scripts research institute. So here you can see the Vina folder. In the Vina folder, you are having these three files. Just copy this file and place it in your Vina docking file. So now we are having the scripts file, that is the PL file, the Perl script file. Then we are having the three Vina application files, then the configuration file, and I am taking five ligand files and one receptor file in the PDB QT format. So we have done all those files. We are having all those files in the folder. So now it's time for us to type commands in order to run virtual screening in Autodoc Vina in the Windows. So just go to command prompt. So here you can see that's been mentioned space in between these commands. So I'm just mentioning those space in between the commands just to remind you to click the space button in those places. So don't type space as given below, just click the space button. So that's why I have mentioned that. And also the commands which is in red color only you have to be typed in the command prompt. So first one is the cd space slash. Okay, just type cd space slash, enter. So after you have entered, so second one is cd space folder pathway. Okay, so here you can see the folder pathway. This is the folder pathway. So just copy this folder pathway, and here cd space folder pathway, enter. So next step is, okay, dir space then we are having slash capital B space, then greater than symbol, okay, then again space ligand dot txt, enter. So after this step you have to go and check your folder. There's been a new text document been created in your folder. So this is the ligand text document. It's been newly created, automatically created. So when you visit this document, you should remind that in this text document there should be only the name of your ligand files. Just remove all the other files. So I am removing all the other files. I'm just keeping the ligand files. Okay, I am having the 5 ligands, so I'm having it here. Just save it. Okay, just close it. So just make sure that you are having only the ligand files name in that ligand text document. So next comment is, okay, type pole space. Okay, type pole space. Pole space vina underscore windows dot pl. Okay, just enter. Okay, it's asking me the ligand file, so you have to type ligand dot txt and enter. Okay, now the Autodoc Vina starts to run. Autodoc Vina, it runs for each molecule, so it takes some time for each molecule to get docked in the binding site, so you have to wait. It will take some time. So this is how it's going to perform, it's going to proceed further. So now you are seeing in the screen that is it, the Vina, it takes the first ligand, that is 122.pdbqt as the first ligand, and it starts to proceed. So it starts to proceed from 0% and it finished by reaching the 100%. So once it finishes by reaching the 100%, just go to the folder and see there's been extra 2 files created in your folder for each ligand files. So now I'm taking the 5 ligands. For each ligand you will get 2 extra files created in your folder. So at the end of this whole process I'm getting the 10 files newly created in my folder. So this is how it proceeds further. So this the time consumption for running this virtual screening in the Autodoc Vina, it totally depends on how many molecules you are taking and your system's performance. So it's only based on those things. So it will take some time. So guys, it's going to be get over for my first ligand. So you can see, okay, for my first ligand I got the results. Okay, my first ligand, it binds with this protein with the binding energy of -9.8. so when you look into this virtual screening folder, you can see there's been a 2 files created for your each ligand. So my first ligand is 122. So you can see there's a two files created for my first ligand. For one is 122.pdbqt_log, that is a text document, and second one is in the pdbqt file. So you will just open the text document. So in the text document they are being given a binding energy for each of my ligands conformation. So my ligand is binding with this protein with the -9.8 binding energy kilocalories per mole. So okay, and you have to open this 122_out, that is in the PDBQT format file in the PyMOL. So just open those file, just open that file in the PyMOL. Okay, not talking. Okay, so just open the, okay, now you can see the ligand that binds to my target molecule. So here you can see, just when you click this, so that's a forward and a backward option. Just click and you can see the those 10 conformation of my ligand in that specific exact binding site. You can also see this conformational change as a movie in this PyMOL visualizer. Just go and click here. So you can see the all 10 conformations of my ligand. So in the text document, we can see the binding energy for the each of my ligands conformation, and in the PDBQT, that output file, you can see the, you can actually visually see the ligands 10 conformations in PyMOL. So that's how you have to analyze your results. So now the winner is getting run. So just we have to wait. So guys, I have got all my results. Autodoc winner run. Finished all my ligands. So in the folder you can see there's been an extra two files created for each of my ligands. So now we are going to investigate which among these five ligands, which ligand binds with the target protein with the least binding energy. Okay, 758 is binding with -9.9, and this binding with -9.5, and this binding with, okay, -9.9, and this binding with, okay, -9.7, and this ligand binds with -9.8. So I think this 194 and 588, these are the two ligands. It binds to my target protein with the -9.9 kilocalories per mole. So this is how you should analyze and investigate your virtual screening results. And also you can open these output files. You can see those output files. So you can open these output files in the PyMOL and see your ligands 10 different conformations. So this is how you can do virtual screening in AutoDoc Vina, guys. So that's all for the today's video, guys. Thank you so much.